break this relationship between God and man, but now let me break this relationship between man and man. It is, after that relationship was broken, now here Adam talking about, Lord, it's this woman you gave me, broken relationship. Yeah. They have kids, now the kids are at one another. This is a broken relationship, and you know if you do that, no discipleship can take place. He is on hold, so he wants to break the relationship. I heard you earlier, it's time to forgive and let it go.
Yeah,
work. And protection for enemies. But that ain't who I really need protection from. My biggest protection is not from Satan. It's not the enemy, it's the inner me.
The
Lord in my valley. Because 9 times out of 10, I'm in my valley because of my choices. I can't blame God. I can't blame nobody else. It's my choices that got me in this valley. This ain't my cross. This is my crop. And so, Lord, I need you to protect me from me. Because I don't want to. That's something I don't want to do. That's time I tell Greg that sometimes, listen, sometimes I don't want to pastor. I don't want to preach. I don't want to go. I want to sit at home like everybody else does. There's times when I don't want to forgive. I want to speak in a known language to you two.
Yeah.
What the Lord is leading you, he said, your cup is bring me back to where I started.
Yeah.
And so I'm like the children of Israel.
Yep.
Listen, I should have already been in the promised land.
Say
but it's taken me 40 years to get there because I am not trusting God.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
That's obedient.
And I'm done. Lastly, let's experience the Lord's persistence.
Mm-hmm.
Because in verse 6 it says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
That's right.
What about this persistence? What about this persistence? In his persistence, he gives us some insurance.
Yep.
He gives us some insurance. I'm going to say it again. Somebody missed the opportunity to shout. He gives us some insurance. Where's the insurance in the text? It said the insurance is what's following you.
Yes, sir.
What's following you is your insurance. And he says goodness and mercy.
Yeah.
Grace and mercy is following you all the days of your life. So that's your insurance plan.
Yeah.
Listen, when I get car insurance, whenever I have an accident, all I got to do is call them up because I already paid for my insurance. But the good news about this insurance versus that insurance, my bill has already been paid. I ain't got to make no payments. I ain't got to worry about missing payments. It's paid in full. So I'm covered. And you know when he paid in full, when he died on the cross, he rose again. And so it's already paid in full. So I have insurance. I have grace.
Yes.
What is grace? Grace is getting what I don't deserve.
Yeah. Yeah.
Listen, God gives me another chance even though I don't deserve it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And according to Romans 5:20, I can never out-sin God's grace.
That's right.
Because if God's grace is here, my sin is here, it's always going to out, his grace is always going to oversee my sin. So if my sin did pick up, his grace picks up.
Right.
But then you got to keep on reading in the chapter 6, you say, now that you understand his grace, you don't use that as a credit card.
Yeah.
Say, that, hey, I'm covered. I'm covered. I got some grace for when you fall.
Yes,
sir.
But not only does he give, insurance is grace, but also mercy. And one thing I love about God's mercy is not getting what I do deserve.
Right.
And even though I have to deal with battles because of my choices, can you imagine if God gave you what you deserve? No. The Lord, in Lamentation, it tells us that his mercy is new every morning. So guess what this is? So while you sleep at night, the Lord literally has his apron on. He's taking up you a batch of mercy to meet you when you got up. I know it. I know you thought that was an alarm clock that woke you up there. No, that was the oven going up. Your mercy is ready for you in the morning. So he got mercy. Not only insurance, but you got some assurance. And the assurance is that one of these old days you're going to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So God just let me know that what I'm going through right now is only temporary. Because I have the assurance that God is coming, Christ is coming back to get me. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house,
well.
There's a part of me that I wanted to necessarily get rid of.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, remove this from me.
Yeah.
The Lord said, no. My grace is sufficient.
Yeah.
And so when it comes to dark days, I know what it means to have dark days.
Yeah.
But the only reason why I'm still alive right now is because God's presence and his power was in my life.
Yeah.
I'm a person that almost gave up on life several times.
Wow.
And the fact of the matter is, listen, I even gave up after I was preaching, gave up that pain in my past is too great.
Yeah.
There's no hope. I'm going to tell you this. There's no pain that you're going through that he cannot heal.
All right. Yes. Praise God.
And I'm not asking the Lord to remove it anymore. I'm asking the Lord to help me bear it. Because the Lord just showed me that's a part of my ministry. And if I try to get that part of my life, I'm not going to reach those ones who are hurting right now. So I'm learning to embrace my weakness and realize that I am weak. So when you see the Spirit of God move, you'll know that's not me. God will get the glory. Well, the gospel has been preached. Learning how to live with God. And letting God live with you. The doors of the church are open. As we stand, there's the one this morning. The plan of salvation is Romans 10 and 9, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, believe in thy heart, that the Lord Jesus died, buried, and rose again, thou shalt be saved. If you have not accepted Christ as your personal Savior, now is the time. You can invite him in any time. Anywhere, any place. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. He said, the whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The only person that can send you to hell is you. And how is that? Is by rejecting Christ as your personal Savior. Is it maybe there's someone here this morning that has turned their back on God? God never turns his back on us. And you need to come back home. That's like Pastor White said, that when you move somewhere, make sure you got somewhere else to go when you're moving. He said, come on back home. And see, let me tell you something else. If you reject Christ on this side, you can't change your mind when you get, you can't change your mind. You can't turn the heat down, you can't do none of that. But do it now while the blood is warm in your veins. Is that one? He preached this morning. I don't know how. Yeah. The gospel was preached this morning. Is that one?
God bless you. God keep you.
Sent you a dime.
Amen.
And so you need to be here tonight. Amen. 5 o'clock. We'll be out in plenty of time. 49ers is not in it, Brian, so it don't make no difference. Amen. That's how we're saying. And we keep saying next year. Brother Red.
Yes, it works.
Disciples.
If we have love,
real love,
genuine love,
genuine. show enough love. One to another.
One to another.
Amen. And consider yourselves dismissed.
Amen. Come take care. Come take care.